We are back on the road all summer long, and what's better place to kick off our on the road summer series than at the Newport Chowder Cook-off? This year, it's got a new home, and that's Fort Adams, and that's where Brendan is live with all the details about tomorrow's festival. Good morning, Brendan.
Hey, good morning, Will. That's right. We've revved up the Rhode Show ride. We are back on the road. It kicks off, as you said, right here in beautiful Newport, the city by the sea. We're live at Fort Adams. Get ready for the 34th annual Great Chowder Cook-off. We're learning all about it here this morning. If you love chowder, even if you don't, this is the event for you. It takes place tomorrow. We're going to get the scoop right now. Joining me at the moment is Michelle Maker Palmieri. She's the president and CEO of Newport Waterfront Events. Good morning, Michelle.
Good morning. How are you?
I am great. So nice for you to join us. We appreciate you being here. Tell everyone out there about this event. It's a new location this year at Fort Adams. Yes. And what do we really need to know about what's happening tomorrow?
Well, we are thrilled that we found a new home, because back in the fall, we had no idea what the future held for it when the Newport Yachting Center was sold. So we were across the harbor for 33 years with this event. And luckily, we got approvals back in by the nick of, I can't even tell you, in April from the state, the DEM, and the city to bring it all over to Newport, to Fort Adams State Park. So to keep it here in Newport, but at a new location, which actually is much larger, has more open space, and it has grass. We've never had grass. It's always been pavement, hot pavement in the Newport Yachting Center. So it's 34 years. You can expect amazing chefs and competitors, everything from a tavern to a culinary school to even a nursing home, bringing the best of clam and seafood chowder out again.
So if you're a chowder aficionado, even if you don't know much about chowder, you have the opportunity to learn something as well and just experience all that this great location, this great event has to offer. Tell people about the hours, what they need to know.
Noon to 6. Noon, gates open. We are here all day until, 5 o'clock is when voting stops. So if you do want to get your vote in, you want to make sure you're here before 5 o'clock. About 6 o'clock, we will do the award show. We have ongoing entertainment. We have reggae. We have rock. We have kids entertainment. All kinds of stuff happening.
Fantastic. You don't want to miss it. And I want to turn my attention to this guy, Michelle. We appreciate it. This is Chef Nuno Souza from the Bristol Plymouth Vocational Technical and School Culinary Program. Good morning, Chef Souza.
Good morning.
Nice to have you here. What do you hope? You bet. What are you hoping that people really take away from this? You're going to have your chowder on display, but they can come out. They can experience your culinary masterpieces. It's going to be great, isn't it?
It is going to be great. I think, first and foremost, it's just a wonderful event. You get to taste a lot of different chowders from, great chefs from all over the region. Hopefully they take away that, Bristol Plymouth Vocational School in Taunton is a great school. We offer a lot. We have a great restaurant. They can come visit us and have chowder there all the time.
Absolutely. It's going to be a wonderful event. And may I sample?
Absolutely.
Get that lid off there and let the kids see. Oh, look at this. I'm getting in there. Get up very close to your sets. Here we go. Oh, that's good chowder. That's good chowder. Thank you very much, Chef Souza. Appreciate
it. Thank you very much, and have a great day.
He's leaving me hanging. That's what he's doing. And Michelle, thank you.
Good to see you.
We want you guys to come on out, experience the 34th annual Great Chowder Cook-off. We're going to be here in Newport all morning long. I'm going to be sampling. You don't want to miss it. For now, back to you.
It's an event that we look forward to every year in kickoff of summer. It's the Great Chowder Cook-off is back. And this year, everybody, it's got a new home in Newport. So we sent Brendan out on the road to check out everything that's going on at Fort Adams. Hey, Brendan.
Hey, Will, that's right. We are at that new home, Fort Adams. As you said, it's the 34th annual Great Chowder Cook-off. Get fired up. It starts tomorrow at noon, and it runs until 6 p.m. Newport, the city by the sea, is the place to be this weekend. And right now, we've got some more special guests. We'll open with this gentleman to my left. His name is Rick Nagel, and he is the executive director of the Fort Adams Trust. Good morning, Rick.
Good morning.
Nice to have you with us here today. Talk about what it really means to have the Great Chowder Cook-off here at this beautiful site, Fort Adams. It doesn't get much better than this, does it?
Well, it's certainly a great place for the Chowder Cook-off. It's an institution. We're an institution. Perfect fit and an even better water view.
And there's a great history here with Fort Adams. We were chatting about it before we went on. And speak a little bit about that. There's really just a rich sense of history here, isn't there?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, Fort Adams is where America learned how to build huge, complex military systems. I mean, when this place was built, the only larger construction project in North America was the Erie Canal that went all the way across the state of New York. So we were the learning laboratory, we were the NASA of our day, and it is a hugely complex and cool place with everything from underground tunnels to a lost castle complete with moat and drawbridge.
Oh my goodness, it's so palatial, it's so great, the entire thing. And so not only people are going to have the opportunity to experience great chowder, they're also going to get to experience this great land, if you will, and learn something as well.
Outstanding. I sure will.
All right. Well, Rick, we thank you. And turning our attention to my right, these two fine people right here. This is Tim McCann and Sandy Ewick. They are from McTees in Cumberland. Good morning, Sandy. Nice
Good
to
morning.
See you. Thank you, Tim. Good to have you here.
Good morning. Thanks.
Let's talk about how great the Great Chowder Cook-Off is and what your role will be here tomorrow. Talk to us about it, Sandy.
Well, we will be here with our Chef Luis's acclaimed white clam chowder. We basically entered it because our patrons come in and say it's the best chowder they've ever had, so we figured we'd give it a try.
Looks quite delectable. And Tim, what does it mean to you and to McTees to be here representing?
It's actually a great pleasure. We're very fortunate. Sandy's really the owner of the business and runs the business day in and day out.
You just scored some big points.
I hope so, because it's a long ride back to Cumberland if I don't. However, tomorrow is actually our one-year anniversary of opening.
Oh,
so it's even a different special anniversary for us. So it's our first time doing this. It's our one-year anniversary. Chef Luis couldn't be here. We wish he was. We hope he's at home watching it. And Chef, if you're watching, good work. You'll be here tomorrow, though.
But guys, Sandy, we really want people to have fun, don't we? We want them to love your chowder, but we want them to have a great time, don't we?
Absolutely. That actually was the motto of opening our business.
Fantastic.
What did we want to accomplish? And we just wanted people to come in and have a good time.
Doesn't get much better than that. It's my time to sample, all right? The kid is ready to sample again. Here we go. Remember this? Here comes the airplane. Yeah, I'm about 11 years old here. Oh, yeah. Good chowder. Thank you very much.
All right.
Nice job, Tim. Sandy? Pleasure. Rick, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
It's the Great Chowder Cook-Off, the 34th annual. There'll be chowder like this. Many vendors here. It's Fort Adams. It's beautiful. It's majestic. You don't want to miss it. We'll have more later on. For now, back to you.
We're on the road all summer long, and we're kicking it off today with a favorite local event. It's the 34th annual Great Chowder Cook-Off in its new home in Newport at Fort Adams. Brendan is there now. How's it going, Brendan?
Hi, Audrey. That's right. We're here at Fort Adams. It's an absolutely beautiful morning. Tomorrow's going to be a beautiful day for the 34th annual Great Chowder Cook-Off. I'm very fired up about it. It starts at 12 noon tomorrow. It's going to be a tremendous day. And right now, I am joined by two handsome fellows. I've got Peter Rawcliffe to my right and to my left. This is Chef Scott Thompson. They are from Gridiron Ale House in Warwick. Peter, good morning, sir.
Morning.
You are the owner. Tell us about your great establishment. What do people need to know about it?
Well, we're located in Warwick on Post Road, and we have 37 taps on craft beer taps.
I look forward to sampling all 37.
Oh, thank you.
But no. How great is it for you to be a part of the Great Chowder Cook-Off? Must be just a great experience for you.
Oh, we're really excited about it. It's our first time doing it. I've been coming here for years, and it's going to be a great time. It's going to be good weather.
And it's a great location here, isn't it?
It is.
He's a man of few words, but he gets his point across. This is Chef Scott Thompson. Scott, what does it mean for you as a chef to be showcasing your great work at this event?
It's a tremendous opportunity. I'm grateful for it.
Now, how long have you been a chef?
I've been a chef since I've been working in restaurants since I was 14 years old. Probably like the last 26 years I've been working in restaurants. I was a cook in the Navy, and it just naturally, when I got out of the Navy, I just kept with it, stuck with it. Part of the Chowder Hill Vocational Program, and I'm just really looking forward to showcasing our chowder.
Absolutely. Is chowder something that you've always had an affinity for? Have you always enjoyed preparing it?
Yes, absolutely. As a New Englander and from Rhode Island, I've always loved chowder. It's one of my favorite chowder and clam cakes. Just the two go hand in hand.
Sure do. And when people are experiencing your chowder, whether it's at, the restaurant or whether it's here at, the 34th annual Great Chowder Cook-Off, how does it make you feel when you see them enjoying it and just knowing that, hey, that's your chowder?
Oh, I love it. It's great. It's what I live for. It's why I do it. Just to please people with food and just to be able to feed people is a great opportunity.
And not only that, you got to be in it to win it tomorrow.
Absolutely. That's why we do. That's why you play the game, right?
Absolutely. Well, guys, I'm going to sample away right now. I love the crackers, I love asking for extra crackers. That's my move, and you must love customers like me. That's a good chowder. Nice job, Peter. Thank you, buddy.
Thank you.
And this is Scott. Yeah. See what I've done? Oh, try the chowder. Yeah. Thank you, Scott.
Yeah, you're welcome. Thank you very much.
We appreciate it. The 34th annual Great Chowder Cook-Off. It's tomorrow. You can sample Chef Thompson's delectable chowder. Many different varieties. It's right here at Fort Adams. It starts at noon. You don't want to miss it. For now, back over to you guys.